never been played on an acoustic guitar. No promise sweeter than a blood pact. Nothing harder to go through with than a vanishing. No morning colder than the first frost. No friends closer than the ones we lost. Nothing sharper than a serpent's tooth. Nothing harder than the gospel truth. Though you're a pit and on sackcloth and try to make nice, you can't cross the same river twice. The river goes where the water flows, but no one knows when the back it closed. The river knows where the water flows, but no one knows when the back it closed. There's a club where you'd like to go. You could meet someone who's the most like you. Revel in the darkness like a pair of open dreams. Fumble through the fog for a season or two. No town more barren than our town. No haven safer than the one they tore down. No better love than to lay my life down for a friend. No sweeter pleasure than to see the credits clear through to the end. No one knows where the world has gone. No one sees it camped out right there on the front lawn. We planned for you, but you would not sing. No one's gonna get away with anything. The river goes where the water flows, but no one knows how the battle it goes. The river goes where the water flows, but no one knows when the battle it goes. Here since I wrote it. But it's older than that, because it was a song title in a notebook before it was anything else. And it sat there looking at me, going, make that one good. You know, there's like, there's a bunch of song titles like They Took Charlie's Fish, that's been sitting in the same notebook forever and will probably never be written. About how my friend Charlie likes tinned fish, and I was in Norway, so I got him a bunch of tinned fish, and then at customs they wouldn't let me bring them in. That's as far as that song's ever been. Possum on the porch, probably going to the same place. Though I have higher hopes for possum on the porch. This one sat there for a long time, and I went to the beach with my family, and miraculously, for an hour, the baby was asleep. I had a guitar with me because I'm incapable of not working. And I wrote a a little Johnny Cash thing going. I wrote a verse. I know what song that is. And then the chorus was there. And then the baby woke up. And the baby stayed awake for another 6 or 7 months. So I didn't get back to the song for a long time. By the time I got back to the song, the baby had taken, was no longer a baby, although he will always be the baby to me. It's true. And I couldn't play the guitar around him anymore because he didn't want to hear his songs, which are mainly by Tennessee Ernie Ford, and Grateful Dead, and Webb Pierce and guys like that. And the Beatles, I gotta confess. You may have a Beatles allergy, but when you have children, then you will play them some Beatles songs. To accept your sad fate, the guy with the acoustic guitar playing Beatles tunes. But anyway, I was sitting at the piano, and he came in, and I said, you can hear the demo. Hey, buddy, you ready to demo this jam? And he says, I'm ready to demo this jam. Move the chords over, I can do more exciting things now. I had to then teach myself the chords on the guitar. Because on the piano, they do interesting things like inversions. Interesting to me, I should say. This is a song about a guy who is from here. He went to university here. His name is Andrew Eldrich. And he used to talk up Leeds wherever he went. They would say, where do you like it? He'd go, I like it at home in Leeds, and I like it in Detroit. The song imagines him coming home after a while. It's called Andrew Eldridge and moving back to Leeds. There's a difference on the way when the fame goes to hope at a club nobody goes to, where the musty velvet road, guys in motorhead jackets who knew him way back when. Raised a drink in years, but now we never begin to remember how it was when they all thought they'd move away and ride in Lotus 7s through the London streets one day. Nobody ever gets away. Even the best of us come back someday. Thank you. tell you the bottom machine is a surprise. I don't know if it was Brandon's idea. It was, oh, that's so fucking awesome. Thank you, Brudenell. That's amazing.